The two-stroke diesel engine does not burn as much oil as its gasoline equivalent, which makes its emissions better. Proven in reliability and fuel consumption, the two-stroke diesel engines are responsible for moving the world's cargo and container ships with more than 100,000 horsepower and revving at only 100 RPM. To this day, there are no modern cars on the road with these engines except for somewhat old trucks and buses that used engines from the manufacturer Detroit Diesel. In 2014, Renault claimed to be working on a 70-horsepower, 2-cylinder, 800cc, 2-stroke diesel engine with compressor that would power a car or van with an electric motor, but we'll leave that for later. We'll first see how this simplified version works, which differs from the 2-stroke gas version. We have a piston, a connecting rod, and exhaust valves. There are no intake valves, but there is a port. The port is a simple hole in the bottom of the cylinder through which air enters. The diesel injector is located at the top. There's no spark plug since the mixture ignites by compression and air temperature as in a normal 4-stroke diesel. It is necessary to highlight the need for a blower or supercharger to which you can add the help of a turbo to improve efficiency at high revs. If this blower did not exist, the exhaust gases would go back through the intake port and the cycle could not continue. When the piston's top dead center is reached, diesel is injected into the cylinder and ignites, burning and expanding, pushing down the piston. Upon reaching the intake port at the bottom, the exhaust valve in the head opens. Air from the blower enters and pushes the burnt gases out of the cylinder. This produces an efficient sweep of the cylinder, leaving clean air ready for future burning. This gas circulation from the bottom to the top is called uniflow scavenging. You can see that some clean air goes out the exhaust, but since the air has no fuel mixture, no waste is produced. The piston begins to rise, blocking the port. And at the same time, the exhaust valve closes. The piston continues to rise and compress the air. Upon reaching the top, the diesel is injected again, completing the two-stroke cycle. The main difference with a two-stroke gasoline engine is that there's no blower, since the gasoline engine uses the vacuum generated by the piston when it goes up, and thus introduces the mixture of air, fuel, and oil inside the block, and then, when the piston descends, pushes it into the cylinder, where it is then compressed and burned. In this diesel, at no time the fuel mixture has to pass through the crankcase. Therefore, the crankcase and oil pan can be filled with oil as in a 4-stroke engine. You will have noticed the existence of an oil scraper ring in the lower part of the piston. This is due to the intake ports. When the piston goes down, the oil would enter the intake ports and then into the combustion chamber along with the air. In this way, oil consumption is greatly reduced. The disadvantage of using ports is that when the piston is at the bottom, the rings do not wear in this area, producing uneven wear in the ring. A detail, the intake port actually borders the cylinder and air intake occurs from all directions. Another con of this engine is that the blower must supply air from very low RPM in order for the engine to start. This means that at high RPM, the compressor does not have as much performance, and that is where the combination with a turbo comes in. You can't use a turbo without a blower because the turbo doesn't spin at low revs and therefore the engine can't start. As a consequence, when the turbocharged engine runs at high RPM, the compressor remains belt connected and reduces efficiency. But back to the initial question. Why is it currently only used on ships, locomotives, or heavy vehicles? That is, if they're efficient in those areas, why not in cars? 1. The ships are large and have space to install auxiliary electric compressors to supply air during engine startup, and then the high-efficiency turbo to work. However, with the appearance of electric turbos, which are still under development, this would no longer be an obstacle. Electric turbos can run on the car battery regardless of whether the car is on or off. 2. A small diesel car engine of only 0.8 liters and 2 cylinders must rotate between 1,000 and 4,000 revolutions to generate useful power. At that speed, camshaft overlap must be used, and due to uniflow scavenging, some air is leaked to the exhaust, bringing NOx problems. Also, thermal efficiency reduces. A container ship engine, due to its large space available, can be 25,000 liters, weigh 4 million pounds, and therefore rotate at only 100 revolutions, producing a lot of power. The low rotation makes the combustion stroke last longer, and therefore, at these low RPMs, the 2-stroke diesel engine ends up being more efficient than a 4-stroke, being able to reach a thermal efficiency of 55%. In summary, at very low revolutions, the 2-stroke is more efficient. but with so few explosions per minute, it must be large to have usable power. Imagine a light and small engine so that it can enter under the hood of a car of only 1 liter of displacement, rotating at 100 RPM. It would literally produce no power, and if you make it spin at 3 or 4,000 RPM, the efficiency would drop below 4 strokes. 3. Another point is that ships also use a midpoint crosshead with a fixed piston rod. This is because the piston stroke is extremely long, and above all, the crosshead absorbs all the lateral efforts that occur in a conventional engine. In this way, the oil required in the cylinder area is very low, reducing the consumption of oil caused by the ports. This makes the engine to be several floors tall. It should also be noted that the optimum rotation speed of the propeller is just 100 revolutions per minute. By rotating at the same speed as the engine, a gearbox is not needed, which prevents losses and increases efficiency. 4. Two-stroke diesel engines are good at burning very cheap fuel, such as poor-quality heavy fuel oil or bunker oil. The same ship has a treatment plan to improve the quality before being sent to the engine. However, the emissions produced by these ships, compared to equivalent four-stroke diesel cars, end up being several times higher. The difference is that being on the high seas, the anti-pollution regulations are not as demanding, and there are no people around to inhale the gases as if it happens in a city. However, if premium diesel fuel were used, the emissions would go down. There's also the two-stroke diesel engine with opposed pistons that has been used since the year 1900 in many ships and even submarines. The engine has no cylinder head, no camshaft, valves, valve springs, and other parts that reduce efficiency. Note that they also use the second oil scraper ring. The intake and exhaust ports are perfectly positioned, and by being one above and one below, the emptying and filling of the cylinder is improved to extreme levels. Due to the fact that fuel is burned twice as often as in a four-stroke engine, the power at the same displacement ends up being 50% greater, and therefore giving a lighter engine which reduces the total weight of the vehicle, which ends up contributing to fuel consumption. Acadis uses these engines for modern trucks where they claim a thermal efficiency of 55%, although these values are quite high for such small, high-revving engines compared to 100 RPM ships. There's another two-stroke variant with triangular-shaped opposed pistons called the Deltic engine. This engine was used in locomotives in England for a long time. It has three crankshafts, two rotate clockwise while the remaining counterclockwise. These are then joined by big gears ending in a single output shaft. Oh yeah, what happened with the two-stroke Renault car engine? Well, approximately 10 years passed and we don't have any news by now. Share the video with your friends and leave your like, that helps me a lot. Comment what you think and subscribe. See you next time.